win!
I gotta say, I didn't expect it.
What do you mean kill all of this guy? Why didn't you expect it?
Well, oh, let me guess, the second half of a back-to-back? Well, it was more Martin Jones versus Igor Shesterkin. That's why you didn't think the Leafs were gonna win? Well, I mean, listen, only one of the goalies in this game is top 100 all-time in goalie games played, games started, wins, and saves. And it's not Igor!
Gee, okay, I didn't know you would defend Martin Jones this hard.
I didn't either!
Let's go!
Good, we all feel good.
Stop! Never gets rusty!
What am I doing?
Get in my kitchen! Producer Drew, can you fix all this?
And when it comes to the Toronto Maple Leafs, you can crumple yeet!
Saw that going differently.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Leafs win!
Am I doing this wrong? I've almost been doing this for... Leafs win... Yeah, no, it's... But what usually goes up first?
They lost one game in overtime and I forgot how to do it?
Leafs win! 7-3! Over the New York Rangers. In MSG, on the road against a team leading their division, second half of a back-to-back, with their third stringer in net, playing 11 forward, 7D.
Folks, I think we can make this long conversation short. The Leafs are good.
Like, dude, am I totally comfortable with the goaltending situation? No, I'm not. Could one injury change everything? I mean, yeah, every team's one injury away from something. But dude, the highs and the lows, the comebacks and the chokes, the games that they deserve to win, the games that they did not, the games where they found a way, the regulation wins or the lack thereof, they got one in this one, and the lack of regulation losses. The Leafs are 9-1-3 in their last, how many games is that? 13 games? That's preposterous! Not to mention those 9 wins in 13 games have come in 3 different countries on 2 different continents!
And how many time zones? Let me think about that.
All those West Coast games are in January, if you've been wondering where they've been hiding. It's January, though. You see, stay up late. Stay up late in January! That's when you're gonna work out, right? New Year's resolution and all that.
Yeah, don't worry, me too.
But I tell you what, Austin Matthews has already committed to his New Year's resolution, where he's just gonna be the best goal scorer in hockey again.
Bro, Austin is so hilarious. Bro, can I explain how hilarious Austin Matthews and William Nylander are?
So before the game, Matthew Nyes is announced he's not going to be in the lineup. And that's a big opportunity for someone on account of Nyes is on the top line. Now we know guys are not at 100%. It's rare that a team full of 20 players surrounded by gosh knows how many trainers and coaches, and it's the dad's trip, they probably have a number of players feeling under the weather. So they throw fourth liner Noah Gregor up onto the first line left wing. And they got this dude an assist in less than 4 minutes. And I'm gonna show you it in stills. It's hilarious. All right, you might notice Martin Jones is at the bench. That's because the Rangers just took a penalty. The Leafs had the extra attacker. Noah Gregor is there in the middle of the screen, dropping the puck for Austin Matthews. That's it. That's the assist. And then he just goes to the bench. So he drops the puck off for Austin Matthews at the 16:22 mark. He just literally drops it off. Matthews carries it. He drops it off for Nylander. Nylander, good job finding a way into the zone, battling. Gives it to Austin, who's wide open. Don't do that. Snipes it! That is with 16:08 to go in the first period, a full 14 seconds after Noah Gregor dropped it off for his second assist of the season. First of all, I'm not making fun of Noah Gregor. After the game, Luke Fox tweeted this out. When Sheldon Keefe learned Matthew Nyes was too sick to play, it took him about 3 seconds, in quotes, to put Noah Gregor on Matthew's top line. Just think, Sheldon Keefe could have made the decision to put Noah Gregor on the top line 4.5 times in between him passing the puck to Matthews and Matthews scoring. Dude, it's the best, and the Leafs are up 1-0 early. Also the best. Barely over a minute later, off of the faceoff, the third line is out there in the ozone. Connor Timmins just rips it, and is that Igor Shesterkin? All I'm saying is that the Rangers have Igor Shesterkin and Jonathan Quick, and I don't know if you've looked at their stats. Have you ever seen the film Freaky Friday? The Lindsay Lohan film, it was very successful. But you see Shesterkin reacting like this and throwing his hands up. Oh, that's terrible body language from a goalie fighting it right now. And the Leafs are up 2-0 early. Ah, but here's the New York Rangers to remind us where our place is. This is Madison Square Garden. If you can make it here, you can make it anywhere. This is gonna be a difficult night. Rangers with a flurry. Jones makes the initial save and then slowly, vaguely glides out of his net, and Blake Wheeler shoots it into the open net. Sometimes I think I forget that I shoot these videos on a bouncy ball, and if I shift over, I'm just gonna fall. And if that's news to you, it's this. This is what I sit on every video. That's why I'm so bouncy. It is a little funny getting upset on this sometimes. Like when I have to be serious. How dare you? and I'm just sort of, you know, bouncing there. Anyway, the Leafs get the two quick ones. The Rangers answer right back 35 seconds later. Oh, this is going to be a crazy one. And then it slows down. There's no goals for 10 whole minutes. Can you believe it? At one point in this game, the Leafs had 2 goals on 4 shots. The Rangers had 1 goal on 2 shots, and half of the shots were going in. That wasn't always going to stay the same, unless it was. 2023, it's going up. But then the man, the myth, the legend, John Tavares gets it to, you thought I was calling him the man, the myth, the legend, Cali Yarncroak, dude. He backhands it into a wide open net to make it 3-1 with his 7th of the season already. And I'm going to remind you that last season with the Leafs, Yarncroak's been in the league for years and years and years, was his first 20-goal season. If he stays healthy and maintains this pace, he's gonna snore past 20 goals. And you know what? I had a bit of an epiphany in this game. Because the Leafs signed a winger. And they gave this winger a pretty decent amount of money. And for the first, like, 5 games of the season or so, you're like, hey, this guy's not very good. And by around game 10, 12, you're like, uh-oh, the Leafs have made an egregious mistake. Then just kind of quietly, subtly, you're like, wait a sec, is this player just sort of getting out of it by just sort of doing all the right things and being defensively responsible and chipping in offensively when they can? And then that slowly graduates to, wait a sec, this player's just sick? Okay, great. Am I talking about Cali Yarncroak last year or Tyler Bertuzzi this year? Dude, that Yarncroak signing, I hated it early on last year. Tyler Bertuzzi, I hated it early on this year. Both are incredible players. Sometimes it just takes a minute, and we gotta be patient. Steve, who the heck is we? I was plenty patient. All right! Yelling at me through the screen. And only 21 seconds after this Yarncroak goal, Austin Matthews, like, he's just having a fun time, man. You know, Colby Armstrong always says, read the game notes. He usually means for the other team. No. Matthews read his own team's game notes. And tonight, he decided, no. I only want to help people get their second assist of the season. Because he gets a nifty little pass from William Lagesson, and he connects with Marner. Ew. Oh, dude, this goal is nasty, and Mitch, I mean, what slump are we talking about? Just yesterday, I talked about Mitch Marner's expected goals for percentage numbers, as highlighted by Kevin Papetti. And yeah, those numbers are poor and a point of concern. His counting stats are there. His skill has always been there, and his effort is definitely there. His care meter is way up at the tippy top of the team. Maybe it's even too high at times. But sneakily, there you go. That's already his 10th. And Matthews, competing for the Cy Young Award apparently, gets his 21st goal later in this game. That's his 10th assist. Aw, look at you passing. The Leafs take a 4-1 lead into the second period, and there's no way they could screw this up. We're 3/4 of the way through the second period. You could have basically missed most of the second period. It's a snore fest. There's no way they're gonna screw this up. Power play, oh no. Mika Zibanejad, oh no. Blake Wheeler, point blank, oh no. Zibanejad with his 8th, Wheeler with his 4th, and just like that, the Rangers are within 1 on home ice, Leafs second half of a back-to-back, sick, probably, with their 3rd stringer in net, and he might be sick. And then Marner, I tell you what, does a great job. At the beginning of the 3rd period, he goes over to his old friend Eric Gustafson. That guy was a Leaf for a hot minute. That dude was in game 6 against Tampa. He's in the photos. Well, Marner draws an interference penalty off him, and then he scores the power play goal himself. I love when players do this. They draw the penalty, they score the goal. Matthews, his 11th assist. It's the season of given. Morgan Rielly picks up another point. Stay hot. This power play. Stay hot. Marner, stay hot. Leafs back up 2. Rest of the 3rd period goes by. Rangers with 13 shots in the 3rd, but Martin Jones stands tall. And then with less than 3 minutes to go, Nylander to Austin. This just felt mean. His league-leading 21st of the season. Uh-oh. Before about a minute and a half later, with the empty net and the hat trick. No. Don't get cute. David Kampf taps it in. 3rd goal in 4 games, and we are not going to ask questions about how. The Leafs, feeling it. The fans, feeling it. The dads even, feeling it. Jones with his first win as a Leaf, and I tell you what, the Leafs were losing with less than 7 seconds to go just yesterday against the Islanders, and over the course of a weekend where they're shorthanded due to injury, they're on the road, they're feeling sick, they pick up 3 out of 4 points. That's been the story of this team this season, or at very least over the last month. They battle. This is the hardest that I've seen the Leafs work this consistently in a very, very long time. Like last year's team, you know, hindsight and all that, it maybe doesn't get the love it deserves because by the end of the season, the horses they got at the deadline, like, they were working. But, like, this isn't how they usually play in December. Like, they've gone on streaks and gotten hot in December, but, like, there's something different here. Like, this Leafs team is a long night. Take, for example, the Tampa Bay Lightning, and the Leafs have had great success against the Tampa Bay Lightning recently. The Lightning are a long night, though. Even if you beat them, it's a long night. You're gonna have to rely on multiple 4-1 comebacks to beat them in overtime, by the way. They still get something out of it. Do they have skill? Of course they have skill. Kucherov and Stamkos. Do they have speedy workhorses? Of course they do. Braden Point and Anthony Cirelli. Do they have giants who will make you miserable? Victor Hedman and their entire fourth line. Oh, and a goalie. They're a long night! Even when they're struggling, they're a long night. Very subtly, very quietly, there's really nowhere to hide. Should you be playing Gregor first line left wing every night? Like, did he look fantastic tonight? No. He looked fine filling in second half of a back-to-back on a, what is it, a Tuesday? Is Lajoie gonna be in the playoff lineup? No, but this isn't the playoff lineup, is it? It's December 12th. And who knows, they might even give other players an opportunity. Which is why, before we get to questions, I wanna go back to Nick Barden with Marley Minute early in the week this time. He's been buzzing around Coca-Cola Coliseum, talking to all the players. Here he is with the latest installment of Marley Minute.
Mikko Kokkonen has had a terrific year, likely making him the next defenseman to call up if there's an injury with the Maple Leafs. But what has the 22-year-old done to earn that potential call-up? Well, first, he's trusted by Marley's head coach, John Gruden. Kokkonen's out on the ice in almost every situation for the Marlies, and Gruden says that both Kokkonen and Niemelä, who are both on the same pairing, have grown a lot this season, and even has gone as far as saying that the two are a luxury for the team. The other aspect of Kokkonen's game that stands out is his calmness. When you're a defenseman at that level, you're under pressure a lot of the time. You gotta make passes quickly. And Kokkonen, whenever he's under that pressure, never makes it known that he's under that pressure. His passes are smooth, his skating is smooth, and his overall play is just smooth. And heck, even when talking to one of his defensive teammates on the Marlies and Tommy Miller on Monday, he says that when Kokkonen's on the bike exerting energy, his heart rate is still a lot lower than some of his teammates.
We joked around, you know, we're wearing our heart rates on the bike or something, and like no matter how long you've been riding, his heart rate's always like calm and lower while you're sweating in the red or something. It's pretty funny, but that's just how he is, always just steady, and ask him how he is, it's good. Like, that's just how he is on and off the ice, and you can see it out there, his patience and poise.
So when you put all that together, his smooth play on the ice, his calmness, and the ability to play in all situations, plus the fact that Maple Leafs head coach Sheldon Keefe liked Kokkonen's play during training camp, when you throw all those things together, you have a defenseman on the Marlies that could see his first taste of NHL action sometime soon.
Thank you, Nick. And if you want to follow him on Twitter, it's very easy, actually. It's just Nick, N-I-C-K, Barden, B-A-R-D-E-N. That's it. All one word. Questions. Igor has been very shaky in net lately, had an injury recently, and might not be in top form for a while. What do you think the Rangers should do? I mean, you couldn't have possibly asked for Jonathan Quick to be this good. So, it's interesting. My instinct is to say, well, just play Quick more. You know, he wants the net. He's an intense competitor. Just give him more of the net. But I feel like Igor might be one of those guys cut from the same cloth as Andrei Vasilevsky, where the more you give him the net, the better he'll play. The Rangers know the answer to this better than anyone, but you might not like this, but playing Shesterkin more might be the answer here. Which one of the dads is partying the hardest in Manhattan tonight? Oh man, well, Ty Domi is a key factor in this trip right now. Like, I want you to think about this. All their kids are in the NHL, so they all make bank. Ty Domi is a very key factor in all this, because not only was he a famous Toronto Maple Leaf, he was a famous New York Ranger. He knows all the spots. And Jim Treliving is on the trip, and that dude is on Dragon's Den. Based on the footage and the singing, I'm gonna say Mr. Brian Matthews, I think Austin's dad, might get after it. Big two-goal performance. He was singing, he was dancing, he was, even when a goal didn't go in. And sneakily, David Kampstad. I didn't learn until way too late in life that Pilsner is actually a city in the Czech Republic. This isn't a question, it's just Nick Richard. Oh my goodness, I forgot to mention this. Showing Jake McCabe hitting, is that Ryan Lindgren? Look at this. Here's an angle. Here's another one. Ooh. Here, show another one. Show one. Man, that was a clean hit too. That is a good day, man. And they can't take their foot off the gas, all right? You can't. You got Columbus coming up. They've had a rough run of late. That's a trap game. That's a trap game. You gotta put your foot down. And I was gonna talk about the Penguins on Saturday. I'm doing a stream for that game, but focus on the task at hand. Prepare for Thursday first. For now, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. Na 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 na.